The foundation to SEO is keywords. If you have a lot of valuable keywords within your website, within your content, you can get more traffic. If you don't have the right keywords on your website, you won't get traffic no matter how much SEO you do. So the real question that comes to mind is, how do you easily find keywords? Hi everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm gonna break down an easy way to find more keywords. Now, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel, and if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. The first thing I want you to do if you really want to find more keywords is to download the Ubersuggest Chrome extension. So go to the Chrome extension store, download Ubersuggest, and once you do, you'll see a little U right here like you're seeing on my screen. If you don't, click the little extension icon and just pin the Ubersuggest extension. Now, the first easy way to find more keywords is to just do Google searches. Whenever you do a Google search like this, I did one for VoIP, you'll see the number of monthly searches. And when you click View All, you'll see trends. How many of those searches are from mobile devices versus desktop? Typically, desktop traffic converts better. The cost per click, the paid difficulty, the SEO difficulty. The lower the score, typically the lower than 50, the easier it is to rank for. And the higher the cost per click, the more valuable this keyword is. You can also see the searcher's age range. The older they are, usually the more valuable the keyword is. And you can also see how many people actually click on the results from SEO to paid to no clicks at all. Now, as you scroll down, you'll see data on a lot of the websites that rank at the top. Now, what I want you to do is I want you to first go to the sidebar where you see a laundry list of keywords. And you'll see suggestions, questions, prepositions, comparisons. First, I want you to look at the related keywords in the right sidebar. This will give you more keyword ideas, and it's broken down by SEO difficulty. Look for the keywords that are less than 50, and then look for keywords that have a high CPC. Anything more than a few bucks usually is good. And then, of course, the higher the volume, the better as well. And you can continue to do this for many different keywords. Like I can type in voice over IP or VoIP service. And as I type this into Google, Ubersuggest will load. It'll again show me the monthly searches CPC at $55. That's quite a bit. And again, it'll provide me with more keyword recommendations like the best VoIP service, right? $40 plus cost per click, 38 SEO difficulty. Not a bad keyword. And depending on the country you're in, you can adjust it right here by just clicking on the flag. And it'll adjust based on whatever region you are in. Now, the next thing I want you to do is to go and look at a lot of the random sites that rank. So I'm going to go to Nextiva. I know they're on a paid ad, but you can do this for a paid ad or organic. And you know, I'm going to go to their homepage. You can technically be on any page. Click on the Ubersuggest U icon. It'll load. It'll give me ideas of how many organic keywords they have. I love my honey extension that helps me save money while I'm shopping. But it shows me how many organic keywords I have, organic monthly search traffic, backlinks, domain score. And you can see their traffic over time, how many keywords they rank for in different positions. You can even see their top pages by country. And then you can drill down to view the estimated visits. This ends up taking you to the Ubersuggest app. And as you can see, it's telling me some of the keywords that they're ranking for that page. That's one of their top pages. And I can see it for a lot of different pages, how to call Mexico from the US. And it'll show me more keywords as well. So that also gives me ideas. On top of that, when I go to the Nextiva website within the Ubersuggest Chrome extension, you can click on top keywords. And this is an easier and simpler way. And as you just scroll through it, you can see more and more keywords. And using the same metrics, right? Low SEO difficulty, high volume, high, and estimated visits, actually how many visits they're roughly getting to their website from that keyword. But high volume and low SEO difficulty, those keywords will give you an idea on, is this worth going after or not? So that's where I would start. If you do this for your website, you'll find tons and tons of keywords when you go to competition websites, type in keywords, it'll give you more keyword ideas. And then on top of that, then what you'll want to do is then go and create content based on the top pages that are working for the competition, which I showed you here, which is what's working for Nextiva, and then go from there and then implement that within your website. Try to create better versions of their pages, although they're doing a pretty good job. And then from there, over time, you'll get more and more traffic to your website. And then if you want to go an extra step and reach out to the people that link out to Nextiva or any of the people that you're looking up, you can then end up clicking the backlinks button, the view all, and it'll show you all the people who are linking to them as well. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like it, subscribe to it, share it. If you have any questions, leave a comment and I'll do my best to answer any questions that you have. Thank you for watching.